The objective for this video is to learn to use the TI graphing calculator to find the critical value and test value for a t-test for the difference between two means for independent samples where the population standard deviations are unknown. In a previous video, we conducted a hypothesis test about the difference between means where samples were taken from independent populations and the population standard deviations were unknown. We used a table to find the critical value of -1.729 and the formula for the difference between means where the population standard deviations are not assumed to be equal to find the t-test value. That t-test value was calculated to be -9.332. We can use the TI graphing calculator to find these values. In order to find the critical value, we will need to know the significance level and whether it is a one-tailed or two-tailed test. In this case, we have a left-tailed test with a 0.05 level of significance. This means that the entire level of significance, or alpha, is in the left tail of the hypothesized distribution. The number of degrees of freedom is 19. Using the TI graphing calculator to find the critical value, we will press second VARS. We will be using the inverse t function, so we should press 4. This is a one-tailed test, so at the prompt for the area, we will input the level of significance. That was 0.05. The number of degrees of freedom is 19. Cursor down to paste and press enter. If you are using a TI graphing calculator that does not prompt for the values, then you will need to place the values in the correct order. The correct order is area, comma, and then the number of degrees of freedom. Press enter. And the calculator gives us the left-tailed critical value of -1.729. We can also find the test value using the TI graphing calculator. To do this, we will need to know the hypotheses. The hypotheses are mu1 equal to mu2 and mu1 less than mu2. So we have a left-tailed test. In this example, we have all of the data values available to us. So we will need to begin by entering them into two different lists and pay close attention to which data set is entered into which list. We should begin by pressing STAT and then 1 in order to enter data values into lists in the calculator. We let the Dodge Charger sample represent group 1, so we should type the data values for the Dodge Charger list into list 1 and the data values for the Chevrolet Caprice samples into list 2. Now press STAT and then cursor over to tests. We are conducting a two-sample t-test, so we should press 4. We have data values in lists, so we should highlight data using the cursor and press enter. Make sure that list 1 and list 2 are set to reference the lists for your group 1 and 2 data sets. Leave the frequency 1 and frequency 2 entries set to 1. Our alternative hypothesis is mu1 less than mu2. So we should highlight that selection and press enter. We are not to assume that the population variances are equal, so at the pooled prompt, we should highlight no and press enter. Now cursor down to calculate and press enter. The calculator then gives us the t-test value of -9.329. The discrepancy between this value and the value obtained in the previous video is due to the use of rounded values when calculating the t-test value by hand. In this video, we learned how to use the TI graphing calculator to find the critical value and test value for a t-test for the difference between two means for independent samples where the population standard deviations are unknown.